Dean, as you know, Beach Park residents getting the all clear yesterday from hazmat teams and returning to their homes and their lives. But those who live near the epicenter of yesterday's chemical spill are deeply concerned about both the short-term and the long-term environmental impact.
Those are golden barberries and those are purple barberries, but they don't look too either colorful right now. It's all looking deader and deader by the hour.
Lyle Caldera says the Environmental Protection Agency has checked out his house and deemed it safe, but the yard is a different story. The Beach Park home where he's lived for 18 years, taking an immediate hit from the spilled anhydrous ammonia. Caldera's lawn and mature pine trees, along with the shrubbery and his neighbor's properties as well, clearly impacted by yesterday's spill. A pair of 2-ton tanks being towed by a tractor on Green Bay Road and 26th Street causing the spill. The contents of those containers spilling out onto the surrounding properties. And to add insult to injury, Caldera getting the bad news just a short while ago that his insurance company won't pay for damage to its yard with its extensive collection of shrubbery.
The insurance company said there's nothing they can do. A hazardous gas is not covered under their insurance.
Really?
Yes.
Astonishing news for Caldera and other residents who are finding out the same thing. Then there's his well water. The Lake County Health Department and EPA are testing the well water to make sure it's safe. Caldera is also worried about his dog, Ginger. Authorities may have given the all clear, but Caldera's been told that there could still be chemical residue on his yard, so he's afraid to let the dog out of the house. No minor inconvenience, any dog owner will tell you. Illinois State Police is investigating the cause of yesterday's chemical spill. The National Transportation Safety Board is also on site, and they have begun their own investigation. The NTSB, as well as the Lake County Sheriff, are expected to have an update on all of this. And we will, of course, bring you the very latest on the WGN News at 4.